welcome to another edition of 1987 Scotch Plains Fanwood Raiders football. We're here at Perry H. Tyson Field, where the Scotch Plains Fanwood Raiders are getting set to take on the Hilltoppers from Summit High School. Sean, how does today's game look to you?
Well, the predicament that Scotch Plains in, Scotch Plains now 1-2, cannot lose a game with any chance to make the playoffs. Both teams are young, with only about 5 starters for offense and defensively for Summit Hilltop, and Scotch Plains with many injuries to starters, quarterback. We both have 2 young squads out there. Hopefully it should be a good game.
This is Mike Butt's 3rd week as the starting quarterback. Have you seen him mature at all and get more into the swing of things?
Last week, watching films against Union, Butts really did a good job. He did the best he could. He's kept with his assignments, and the Union Farmers are just too strong. They just kept blasting through that line and getting to him.
That's right. He did have a tough assignment against Union.
Mike Butts is not a bad athlete. He did his job pretty well. He can do it today. I predict a good game.
What's the mood of the team after that loss to Union? Are they pumped for this game? Were they upset? What was the general mood of the team?
Well, they're pretty pumped because they know they can't lose anymore, and they really do feel like they can beat most of the teams on their schedule. They have Summit, Westfield, Rollway, Irvington, Rollway. They have a pretty decent schedule ahead. They can't take any team lightly. They know that. And they prepared as hard as they can for a straight week, and they're going to come out and play as hard as they can here.
Things look better for Scotch Plains after this week, with Ricky Jackson scheduled to come back next week against Westfield. And
Jackson with a great arm, good feet, good moves. He can run that option beautifully, as you saw in the Cranford game. He had 163 yards on the ground in the first half, and he's just something. He knows how to do it.
How's it look for you, Sean? How long before you head back to the game?
Well, it's not looking good. My arm's been pretty weak. It looks like I'm out for the season. So
another season?
Yep, one more.
That's too bad. Are you looking to play in college?
I was until I got hurt again, but we'll see. Might try and be a walk-on.
Yeah, you see the Summit Hilltoppers coming off the team. We'll set their starting lineups right now. Starting at their offense, their end is going to be number 24. He's a sophomore. And it's David Morton. Number 77 will play right tackle. I think that's going to be Dave McClinn. Their right guard is going to be number 55, Spinner. He's a senior, one of the few seniors on the starting squad. Number 53 is going to play center, Schneller. He's another senior. The left guard is going to be the senior, Facinini. He'll play the left guard. The left tackle spot will be handled by Engstrom. He's only a junior. A senior will handle the tight end position. That'll be number 84, Smith. The left halfback will be handled by number 42, Duffy. He's a sophomore, one of 3 sophomore starters for the Summit offense. The right halfback spot will be occupied by Parker, number 33. He's a senior. Junior Fleming will handle the fullback position, and they'll be quarterback by number 8, Chris Cherry, and he is also a senior.
Out on field for the Scotch Plains team, captains number 75, Maurice Owens, and number 50, Nick Nitti.
The Summit captains are going to be captained by number 55, Chris Spinner, and looks like number 84, their tight end, Craig Smith. Starting on defense for the Summit Hilltoppers, it's the tight end also plays left defensive end. That's number 84, Smith. He's a senior. Number 75, Engstrom, is going to play left tackle. Number 77, McClinn, is going to play right tackle. The right end spot will be handled by the senior, Facinini. Outside linebacking positions will be handled by number 25, Fleming, and number 30, Kaufman. The inside backer spots will be occupied by Natal and Chris Spinner. The left corner will be handled by Morton, the right corner by Parker, and the free safety will be handled by number 7, Pete Duhott. A lot of youth in there for the Summit Hilltoppers. These teams are relatively similar. A lot of youth mixed in with some experience. Should be a good game today.
Raiders will be receiving the ball. Scotch Plains Raider Marching Band is going to be playing the national anthem.
As we get ready to hear the Star Spangled Banner. And we're going to get set for the opening kickoff, which will be seen by the Raiders. Back looks deep. Someone has a lot of people that goes both ways. It looks like they have about eight of their offense offenders will also be on the field for defense, which could lead to some tiredness towards the end of the game.
Well, both on the other side, Scotch Plains Raiders, when I was playing 2 weeks ago, we had 10 people going both ways. So they're both teams, I'm sure, are in good shape to be able to get through.
Back deep for the Raiders usually is Corey Anthony, Keith DeFury, and Chris Kresge. We'll see if they keep that trio back there for this game. Keith DeFury had an excellent game last week versus Union, one of the standouts for Scotch
Plains. He's a sophomore. He came out first game playing as a linebacker, about 5'8", 140 linebacker, sophomore. He's got some good speed. He's a tough guy. He can stick it with anybody. You're right, back deep. Number 18, Chris Kresge. Number 25, Corey Anthony. And number 41, Keith DeFury.
Kicking off for the Summit Hilltoppers, I hope that's her name, is number 16, Doug Mann. As we get set for this game to get underway. And this game is underway. It's received by Corey Anthony. Wall sets up. And Anthony is taken down by number 35, John Washington. And Scotch Plains will start with relatively good field position on about the 25. Last week against Union, if we got that far up the field, we consider ourselves lucky.
Last week we had a couple problems with them. They're a pretty strong team. Number one
very
in state
team.
For how many years in a row? State champs every year. They're a great team. See what we can do this week. Labus, number 83, split right.
If I remember correctly, Richie Dare got injured last week. Who's going to be doing the punting for Scotch Plains in his absence?
He hurt his knee. A little belly up the middle. The Phil DeFalco looked like no gain. It'll be about 2nd and 10 for the Scotch Plains Raiders. There's Richie Dare, number 82. It looks like he's back. He hurt his knee last week, and he's back in there. Number at the tight end position, number 99, Skip Brantley. Tackle, 71, Dom Cuzzo. Guard, Mike Martin. Center, Nick Nitti. Guard, Danny Suma. Tackle, Mo Owens, 6'2", 275.
Penalty called on that play as it was stuffed. That play was stuffed at the line of scrimmage, but there were flags down offside against Summit, I believe.
In the backfield of the Raiders, we got number 44, Phil DeFalco. He'll be at the fullback position. The wingbacks, number 18, Chris Kresge. Number 25, Corey Anthony. And at the quarterback position, we got Mike Butts. In goes Bobby Labus with the play. It's about 2nd down and 5 to go on the Raider 32-yard line.
Mike Butts looks over the situation, calls the signals. Oh, a little counterplay. Oh, nice move by Corey Anthony.
He avoided tackle definitely in the backfield. He made one good move, but then the Summit defense just came back up and made a swarm. About 3rd and 8 now. Loss of about 3 on that play. There you see Richie Dare, number 82, going in with the play. Raiders usually switch in their wideouts each play, bring in the play, tell the quarterback, keep them fresh for those long bombs.
Butts looks over. I wonder if he'll see a pass here. Kresge goes in motion.
There it is,
little
a roll waggle.
Out. He's going to keep it.
Found the end. Butts has some good speed. When he gets in that open field, he's hard to take down. It looks like he might. He's very close that first down.
Too bad he stumbled there a little bit, or what it may have been a really big game. But as it was, I think they're going to call for a measurement.
Not a bad run. See, that's his play. He rolls out. If he doesn't see his primary receiver, he sees if he can get that in. He got that in. He took it, and that's the way he's got to play. Shows 3 games experience. He's coming out of his shell now.
He really yes, Butts did indeed get that first down. A nice show of athleticism there by Mike Butts, being able to keep his balance after slipping and struggling for the first down. That'll make it 1st and 10 from about the Scotch Plains 36-yard line. Bob Labus splits out wide for the Raiders.
Centering for those Raiders, Nick Nitti. Corey Anthony in motion.
Give the ball up the middle. Phil DeFalco taken down by about 3 Summit defenders.
Phil's got some strong legs behind him. He can carry a couple people. It's going to take more than one person to get Phil down. He's pumped up there.
Flavio Acitelli was in on that stop.
Gain of about 7. It'll be 2nd down and 3rd. Last week, this was a problem. We couldn't open those holes. This week, looks all right from the beginning. In now at right tight end. Tight end is number 80, Andy Lazowski, senior.
He was injured last week.
Yeah, he hurt his wrist.
Another play up the middle, stop like, for no gain.
It's like maybe gain of a yard by number 18, Chris Kresge. He fought for everything he had there.
It's gonna be 3rd and 1. I think Scotch Plains tries to run that option that they've had great success with throughout this year. I better see it here.
I'd love to see him go to the air, just to surprise him right now, but Scotch Plains always pretty much likes to play it safe. We'll see what they do.
As they break the huddle, Labus comes out wide. Corey Anthony in motion. There it is, the option.
He's got the corner. Hole outside.
Oh.
Oh. He did get the first down after a gain of about 8. Corey had to make that one move. He had a long way to go. If it looks a little slippery today, a couple players been losing their feet. If he kept his feet, he was gone.
That's right. Number 7 there, and on the stop, Pete Duhott. Showed some good speed there by the Summit defender. He came up rather quickly on Anthony. He had tried to force that cutback. Still, 1st down from about the 51-yard line.
We had some good blocking on that left side of the line. 1st down and about 10 to go on the Raider 51-yard line.
Butts calls the signals, takes a snap. Looks like another option, other way. Kresge, oh! He was met as soon as he got the ball by number 24. David Morton was in there to make the stick.
That was some play by that Summit defender. He came up there with great force, just met Kresge at that 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Good read there by the Summit defense.
There you
saw the option developing. The cornerback came up to shut off the pitch. Excellently done.
Predict a waggle pass here.
2nd down and about 14.
There it is.
There it is, a rollout. He's got a man.
He's got the man long.
Oh, thrown a little bit behind the receiver. Had a man downfield, just couldn't reach him.
Butts got clocked after he let that one go from a backside rush by number 75.
Kurt Engelson. Engstrom, a tackle who's 5'11", 180. Summit has some good size on its team. They've got number 78, Gil Labbitt, he plays tackle. He's 6'2", 245 as a junior.
That's some size. How about that sophomore they had?
They've got a sophomore who goes 280 pounds. Number 77, Dennis McLennan, is a sophomore. He's 6'1", 220. They're going to be good in the future. There you go. Straight drop back pass. Little screen. Set up nicely. Good block there by Dom Cuzzo, number 71. He absolutely leveled number 82, Flavio Antoscelli. Great block there by Cuzzo.
That summer defense didn't look too fooled by that screen pass at all. It looked like they were really prepared for that. They kept one guy out there near Corey Anthony. Butts made a good pass, got it just over his head. And those D-backs for Summit came good force up there to get through that Raider line that they had on that outside. It's fourth down, about 6 yards to go. Back punting for Scotch Plains looks like number 12, Noel Sladashny. He's got a pretty good foot.
High snap. Gets it off, takes the Scotch Plains bounce. And it's going to be downed on the 19-yard line. Summit will start their first possession of the day from their own 19. See what the Raiders can do on defense.
They had some good pressure by Flavio Acetelli, number 82. He came in from the outside, just missed that block.
Still a pretty good first series for the Raiders. They moved the ball, threw a couple passes.
Phil DeFalco, number 44, calling them defensive plays. We got Strong N, number 50, Nick Nitti, number 75, Maurice Owens, number 40, Chris Palmieri, number 99 at the weekend, Skip Branley. At the other tackle, looks like number 71, Dom Cuzzo. D-backs, we got number 11, Ananias Battle, number 46, Anthony Cucurillo, number 25, Corey Anthony, and number 18, Chris Kresge.
First play of the game, quarterback Chris, he's got a receiver. Oh, just couldn't do it. Had Scotch Plains fooled on that one.
That was some throw. That was about 30 yards in the air.
That's quarterback Chris Cherry for Summit. Right away, come out firing, trying to hit number 24, David Morton out of the backfield.
They changed that offensive formation three times, trying to throw the Raider defense off balance. They just kept coming back, going with the switches. And this battle got turned around a little bit, and their receiver got a couple feet on him, and he just couldn't hold on to that ball.
That throw is a little bit stronger. They have a touchdown. Chris Cherry looks over the Scotch Plains defense. Called singles. They're gonna go right back to the air. Hit number 85, Bill Wahlberg, right on the hands, just couldn't hang on to it. It's obvious, well, you know what Summit's strategy is to do now, just go right after the heart of the Scotch Plains defense.
They're going right to the air. They put their wide receiver across the middle, sent the tight end straight out. Ananias Battle just missed that interception. He had a nice attempt there. At quarterback, he's got some arm. He threw right through. It's Cherry, number 8. He's got a pretty good arm there.
Third and 10 from their own 19-yard line.
I've never seen Scotch Plains up so tight on defense. Usually they have at least three deep. Little counter, crisscross.
It looks like that was stuffed up by number 75, Maurice Owens.
Scotch Plains doesn't look bad today. They have a lot of, they have eight, nine men up there on the line today. I'm thinking why.
Good defensive stand for Scotch Plains.
Oh yeah, they had 2 yards and three downs. It's now fourth and 8 from the Summit 21-yard line. Deep back for Scotch Plains is number 25, Corey Anthony.
Punting for the Summit team is John Kaufman. Takes a snap, gets off a kick, not a bad kick. Fielded by Anthony at the 25.
Corey Anthony downs it on about the 50. He had to lean down for it, and his knee touched the ground. Play's automatically called dead.
And Scotch Plains will start from excellent field position from their own 50-yard line. They'll see if we can get a score.
We have about 4:44 left in this first quarter. Raiders not bad on their field position, as you were just mentioning.
And you see the time left, about 4 minutes, 30 seconds left to go on the first quarter. Still no score. It's Mike Butts takes the second series. Right up the middle to DeFalco. excellent run there by Phil. Great second effort. Brought down by number 50, Pat Natale.
Phil's just running over. He hasn't gone down yet without three or four guys on his back.
He saw a little seam, popped it right up the middle, and you're right. It takes about three guys to take him down.
He had about 2 yards on that, and he brought another 3 yards carried on his back.
It's going to be second down and five. Call it four. From the 45-yard line of the Summit.
Motion by Kresge.
Same play, right up the middle. Looks like he got a first down.
Another 6 yards by DeFalco. That little belly is working pretty well for Scotch Plains. They're just going to drive it down the field. Two plays, a first down, not bad.
Going right off tackle, having great success.
Each tackled, both Dominic Kuzo and Maurice Owens.
DeFalco, you're right. Just switching the sides. Fumble recovered by Scotch Plains, though.
Good alertness by number 18, Chris Kresge. Phil just couldn't hold on the ball after a pretty good run. He just lost the handle, and Kresge jumps on it for a gain of about 4 yards. It'll be second and six.
Phil, while fighting for an extra yard, a Summit player just came up and put his helmet on the ball.
Sometimes fighting for that extra yard isn't always so good.
Still gained about three and a half yards on that play. You're right, that was the same play right off the tackle. Both sides were having great success.
They've run it three times in a row now. There's the option.
Oh, nice read by Butts as he gets into the secondary.
That was a beautiful run by Butts. He elected to keep it, ducked under that end. Beautiful play by Butts. He ducked it right under and gained for about, what, seven?
Yeah,
nice
seven
play by
yards.
Butts. He
Good
keeps
run.
Losing his feet, but he keeps it up.
First and 10 from about the 24-yard line.
And a tight end again is number 80, Andy Lazowski, coming in for Skip Brantley.
Let's see if they go to the air here. First and 10. Butts gives it right to Phil. He's going nowhere that time. He was met by number 26, Dwight Nichols, and number 82, Flavio Antoselli.
That time, that hole was totally stuffed up. They swarmed it with three guys and nowhere to go. Second and 10 for the Raiders on the Summit 23-yard line.
Rather sparse crowd here today as 2 minutes tick down in the first quarter. Butts calls the signals, roll out, here we go. Yes, he likes to throw it. I think he was just trying to unload that one before he got tackled. Good pressure there by number 77. Dennis McLennan, who's 6'1", 220.
Butts couldn't get to the outside. The right guard has to make a log block on that end, and there was two guys out there. I think he picked the first one he met. Butts couldn't get that outside, had to release it rather quickly.
Third and 10. Butts takes the ball. Oh, counter crisscross. That was met head on. Good play by the Summit. Good discipline by the Summit defense. Brought down by number 72, Paul Fasciini.
Raiders are going to go for it here. They're deep in the Summit territory. Fourth down and 11.
This is an awkward situation. Too far out to try a field goal. Too close in to punt. You have really nothing to lose by going for it. I think we'll see that option again, or an option pass, something of that type, something to the outside.
There's that waggle. Good block by number 18, Chris Kresge, but much pressure.
What a move by Butts.
He just makes it back to the line of scrimmage.
You can see the field must not be in that good of shape. He dropped back, set the throw, and lost his balance, and then he was forced to scramble and run. Couldn't get enough for the first down. He stopped after a gain of about four.
That was a good hit by that Summit D-back. He stayed right with Butts and nailed him.
Sean, you were out on the field. What is it like out there? It seems to be... Butts seems to be having a little trouble getting some footing.
It's a little muddy. It's, you know, ground's pretty, it's stiff, but it's slippery. You know?
Yeah, there's a little bit of water, just enough to make it slippery.
Exactly.
As Chris Cherry takes over for Summit.
40 seconds left in the quarter.
Selman has a long snap count, and they give it right up the middle.
Oh, good stuff by Maurice Owens. He just fired Dan right over the nose, and with a big guy like that right in the middle, you have nowhere to go. Mo just grabbed onto him, and he wasn't going anywhere.
Now, his ball is carried by Paul Fleming.
They pulled a guard on Mo. Mo met him first and reached right around him and got the running back for Summit.
Summit gets set.
Whistles.
So too much time, maybe?
End of the quarter.
Oh. So at the end of the first quarter, the score is still nothing. Good first quarter by Scotch Plains, both offensively and defensively. They're getting good penetration. They're just not able to punch it into the end zone.
Scotch Plains coach, Coach Christador, is out on the field talking to his linebackers. Summit with a very dominant team last year. Looks like they lost most of their starters. They beat Union in a 7-6 game, or was it 7-0 last year? They were very strong.
Good
great
team.
Running back in Fioli. He's not playing this year. He elected to just play baseball this year. Second down and 9 for the Summit. There you see Bruce Colby, coach for Scotch Plains.
Split wide for the Summit team is number 24, David Morton. Chris Cherry with an option. Oh, dragged down by Chris Kresge. That was number 33, Alan Parker.
Chris Kresge, outside defensive back. Those guards for Summit, just got out there and lobbed Chris for a little while. He got off the tackles after a first down was made by Summit. Good second effort by Kresge.
First and 10.
Defensive ends for Scotch Plains have got to get up there and stop that quicker.
First and 10 from the Summit 39-yard line. Cherry. Takes a snap, gives the ball right up the
good
middle.
Good stick by number 41, Keith DeFury, sophomore. He just made great penetration, stuck him right at the line.
Excellent play by DeFury. Was right up in there in the hole, he had nowhere to go.
He gained about 1 yard on that play.
Second down and 9 from the 36-yard line. Interesting to see if Summit goes to the air here. That's what they did their first series, so they've been pretty conservative since then.
Scotch Plains only showing one defensive back. Now they're going to three deep.
The option,
play. Again.
Strung out nicely by Scotch Plains, but Summit back showing good quickness, able to break it to the outside.
He showed some real speed there, beating Corey Anthony, number 25, one of the quickest kids on the team this year for Scotch Plains.
That was number 42, Matt Duffy. Looked like Scotch Plains had good defense there. We're stringing him out. Looked like they're going to use his boundary as an extra defender. Somehow the Summit, somehow Duffy was able to find his team and just cut it right back up the field for a first down. Got to give credit to him there.
That was all speed. Scotch Plains defense did that beautifully. They need more pursuit by the defensive backs and good penetration. There was no help from the backfield that time. The whole front line for Scotch Plains did their job.
The motion by Summit. Oh, they go right up the middle. And finally brought down. That ball was carried by number 25, Paul Fleming. That's the same type of play Cranford had great success running against us. Right inside the tackles.
Exactly. They pop the guards down on the end of the tackle and pop it right inside. Another first down.
Summit seems to be finding the key and moving the ball this time. Scotch Plains is getting good penetration though. Summit has a lot of speed.
defense for Scotch Plains looked a little confused on that last play, switching to the strength, and that was a little mix up there.
.42 goes motion to give the ball right up the middle, and he's going nowhere.
Good stick by number 41, Keith the Fury again. He hit that man hard.
Ball is carried by number 25, Paul Fleming again.
I'd love to see a replay on that one. Timeout by the Raiders.
With 9:43 left to go in the half, score is still 0-0. It's been a good half so far for the Raiders. See, there you got a shot of Coach Cobley out there talking to his defenders, discussing what they're going to do. And we'll be back after these announcements.
What do you know about the new tax law, Fred?
There's a whole lot of changes. But for most people, the tax rates actually went down.
Yeah, but aren't we losing some deductions?
Well, if you itemize, there are things you can't claim anymore, like sales taxes, but personal exemptions have gone way up, almost double. And if you don't itemize, you get an increased standard deduction.
Didn't they take the IRA deduction away?
For some people. But anyone can still put their money into their IRAs, and it'll grow and compound tax-free until you withdraw it, just like before.
Ah, I guess I should find out more about all the changes.
That's right. You know, it's all explained in publications 920 and 921. You get them free from the IRS. You just dial 1-800-424-3676.
Great haircut. Great advice.
Well, thank you, Mr. Folsom. Next. The usual?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, you missed one play there because of those commercials. It wasn't much. Ball is carried by number 42, Matt Duffy, to the outside. It's gonna be a first down for Summit.
He gained about 12 yards on that play. Skip Brantley finally brought him down, pulled him out of bounds. Summit moving the ball rather well this second possession for them.
It's gonna be first and 10 from the Scotch Plains 30-yard line. This drive started all the way back at the Summit 19. You see number 24 goes in motion. That's David Morton.
Summit keeps switching their formations, getting the Raider defense a little confused.
Number 33 got the ball. Oh, and he's met by Anthony Cucurullo.
Nick Nady came from backside from that left end position, came all the way back across the field and tackled that guy with Anthony Cucurillo, number 46, after another first down.
That was number 33, Alan Parker. Simple play, just a sweep to the outside. Scotch Plains end got kicked out and cut it right up inside him.
Scotch Plains linebacker has to be in that gap to take care of that running back. He wasn't there. I don't know where he was.
Chris Cherry again gets set to call signals.
Throwing the Raider defense off with that motion. Shot it right back to that other side.
Oh.
Pretty good stick by Anthony Cucurillo. He saw that play coming after you set back up. He's got to make a little more penetration. Cook, when he sees that play coming, he's got to get up that field a little quicker.
It's going to be
not
second.
A bad play, though.
Ball is carried by Paul Fleming, number 25. It's going to be second down and 6. As the clock ticks down to 8 minutes, 30 seconds left in the half, there's still no score but Summit driving.
Big thing, if the Raiders defense can stop them here and can show what they can do, they'll have a little more moral support. Looks like the same play.
Up the option. Oh! Brought down shy of the goal line. Missed tackle in the backfield for the Raiders, allowed him to get that extra yard. It's going to be first and goal.
Anthony Cucurillo got caught inside, got back outside, dove at him, had a piece of him. Ananias Battle's coming up for the support, and they both just flew by him. Those Summit backs have been showing some great second efforts, as Phil DeFalco has. They've been breaking a couple tackles, showing what they can do.
It's going to be first and goal from about the 2-yard line. with 8 minutes left in the half. Let's hope Scotch Plains can force a turnover here. They go right up the middle behind their center for a touchdown. That ball is carried by number eight, Chris Cherry. Good drive for Summit. They spread the ball around a lot. They didn't give it to one man all the way down the field. You saw it runs by
quarterback
Paul Fleming.
A little quarterback keep there. Just went right over the right side of his center.
That was an 81-yard drive by the Summit Hilltoppers. Saw runs there by Paul Fleming, Matt Duffy, Anthony Parker.
It's one heck of a drive by Summit. Summit elects to keep it. Thrown in the air for the two-point conversion. Totally threw off the Raider defense.
It makes the score 8-0 in favor of Summit.
Good catch by number 25, Paul Fleming. He's a pretty good athlete.
He's having a good game so far.
He's a junior. I'm sure they'll love to have him back next year.
Scotch Plains will get set to receive the ball. Maybe they can tie this game up going into halftime, take a lead. Plenty of time left on the clock. Kicking off for the Summit is going to be number 16, Doug Mann.
Deep for Scotch Plains, number 18, Chris Kresge, number 25, Corey Anthony, and number 41, Keith DeFury.
Mann gets set to kick it off. Not a very good kick, a little short. Fielded by Anthony. A wall sets up. Good wall.
Pretty good wall there.
Stop was made by number 30, John Kaufman.
Corey Anthony left the wall. The wall slowed down a little bit, and he just popped outside of it.
Raiders are going to start with excellent field position. Ball on the 33-yard line. Let's see if they can get this going. They've had good drives. First couple times we touched the ball. Let's see if they can punch it in the end zone this time.
Motion by Anthony. There's that little belly up
DeFalco.
The middle. DeFalco
gets into the secondary. Having a good success with that play, too. Once Phil gets into the secondary, it's tough to bring him down.
Good blocking by the guards and tackles on that play. For Scotch Plains, look like it's going to be close to first down. They're bringing out the chains. Nick Nettie supervising the play. And it's a first down for Scotch Plains. Right now, Phil DeFalco probably has about 50 yards in the first half.
He's had an excellent half for DeFalco. Good half for Mike Butts if he could just stay on his feet.
Scotch Plains likes to stay with the same play. If a play is working, they stay with it. Let the Summit defense switch to it. Let them stop it once and then go the other way or switch the play.
Do a play till they stop it.
Yep. There it is the other way. New fullback in there. That was Keith DeFury, number 41. He's a strong runner, too.
Stuffed that after about a gain of three.
Yep.
DeFalco checks back in. I wonder if he just needed a new mouthpiece or something.
A little breather.
And Scotch Plains sets up to the line. Mike Butts calls the signals.
Motion by Anthony. There's a little counter up
DeFalco.
The middle. Stuffed. Kresge was stuffed right at the line of scrimmage. Those counters aren't working too well today. Scotch Plains better start avoiding those.
Number 24, David Morton, was in on the stop.
It's about third and seven for Scotch Plains.
Someone's very quick. I've noticed that. They got a good speed. Skip Brantley checks off the field for Scotch Plains.
I'm sure they'll go to the waggle here or the option. They like both of those plays.
There it is, the option. Nicely done. Kresge stays on his feet. He keeps going.
First down. Chris Kresge.
Great second effort by Kresge there.
Second and third effort. He just kept
Good pursuit by the Summit defense, but they just couldn't get to him quick enough. He made, avoided two or three tackles. Kresge, good job by Chris Kresge after cutting it back inside, cut it outside, cut it back inside, worked for about 7 yards. They're bringing out the chains again.
Great run by Kresge. Broke a tackle at the line of scrimmage, broke one about 3 yards later, and then just fought for the final couple yards. And I believe they got a first down by about half a football.
Both offenses, both Summit and Scotch Plains, have been moving the ball rather well. Scotch Plains defense is usually pretty strong. They break down, they do their assignments, they do pretty well.
As they clock is stopped for the refs to step to set the change, it scores 8-0 in favor Summit with 5:45 left to go in the half.
Summit does show some great speed. There's that little belly getting to DeFalco.
Oh my goodness, what a run by the...
Great block by Kresge. That linebacker, number 55, had to tackle him to get rid of him.
That's exactly right.
Hey, Scotch Plains may as well do that all day. Keep getting 2 or 3 yards.
Yep.
First downs all the way down the field.
Well, it was a great block there by Kresge. He kept driving his man back even after the play was over.
Number 80, Andy Lazowski's now in there. Owner wide receiver, number 83, Bobby Labus.
He splits wide right.
Motion by Kresge.
Butts rolls out. Good blocking. He cuts it upfield. It's taken down by number 77, Dennis McLennan.
This guy's playing receivers. Better start getting open here. Butts has had some time. He's got
good protection there for Butts. Just nobody open downfield. Decided to cut it up.
Summit timeout.
Kobe checks on the field. 4 minutes, 34 seconds left to go in the half. 8-0 Summit.
Both Scotch Plains and Summit off two big losses last week. Coming to show some oomph for themselves. Showing what they can do. Both Westfield and Union, two strong teams in this conference this year. Very strong teams. They're playing, I believe it's tonight.
Who's that?
Westfield Union.
Yeah, Westfield Union. Premier game in the state so far. Number one, Union Farmers. They have an excellent team. They played really well last week. Their defense just is dominating. As the refs tell the coaches to get off the field. Mike Butts, 3rd and 6 for Scotch Plains. I think we'll see the option here. Nope, just a little counter. Stop was made by number 25, Paul Fleming, for a loss of about 2.
Those counters haven't been working, but they keep electing to go to it.
I don't understand that play call at all. They've had great success with DeFalco up the middle or little options, but instead they go to a counter that's been stopped rather effectively all day.
Maybe they thought they could throw him off or something. 4th and 8 for the Scotch Plains. 4 minute timeout on the field. Kicking for Scotch Plains is Noel Sardashny, number 12.
Good chance for Scotch Plains to pin them deep and they maybe get some good field position and enough time to get a score before the halftime. Still lots of time left. Just under 4 minutes.
As I was saying last week, both teams came off a big loss. Scotch Plains 40-0 to Union, and Summit 43-0 to Westfield.
Next week, Scotch Plains takes on their arch rivals, the Westfield Blue Devils, which is always a good game, no matter what the records. Ball's taken by number 33, Alan Parker, and he stopped at the 30-yard line.
Great run by that guy. He was taken down by number 71, Dominic Cuzzo.
seat for Scotch Plains, Chris Plumeri and
Mike Brennan coming off the field.
Mike Brennan played a good game last week versus the Union Farmers.
That fire for Scotch Plains for the ends was working rather well. We're back to an eight-man front on the line of scrimmage and two deep.
Chris Cherry gives a ball to number 42. Oh, and he's met right on the line of scrimmage.
Looked like that was number 25, Corey Anthony. He got up there pretty quickly, brought him down. Oh, and Keith DeFury, number 41.
Ball was carried by number 42, Matt Duffy.
Backside linebacker 44, Phil DeFalco, was taken out of that play by three Summit defenders. 2:45 left in the quarter, and the half, too.
Summit leads 8-0. That's number 50 centering the ball, Pat. No, excuse me. That's number 53. Steve Schillner doing the centering. There you go, pass.
Oh,
had a man open, just couldn't reach him. Trying, pass intended for number 85, Bill Warburg. It's the first pass they've thrown since their first series, where they threw three straight.
That guy's got a good arm. Corey Anthony was worried about the receiver beating him deep. He finally saw the ball, tried to break on it, it just didn't get there quick enough. Third down and 9 for Summit. I'm sure Scotch Plains right now is in the prevent D.
That's right, try to get the ball back. Third and 9, they'll have about 2 minutes with which to try to get a score.
They can stop it here.
Yeah. Cherry calls the signals. Rollout pass. He's looking for number 24. Couldn't hold on. Pass is intended for number 24, David Morton. Good pattern there by Morton. Just drove the defensive back up the field, stopped, turned around, but couldn't hang on to the ball.
That guy, Cherry, quarterback, he's got one strong arm, and his receivers just can't seem to be holding on to that ball.
He's a senior. He's only 5'8", 150. Plays bigger than that.
Deep for Scotch Plains, number 25, Corey Anthony.
Doing the punting for Summit is number 30. John Kaufman, good punt taken by Anthony. Oh, good coverage by Summit. Taken down by number 82, Flavio Antiselli.
Scotch Plains going to be starting this last drive with about 2 minutes left to go in the half. See what they can do with it. There's a flag, though. Looks like they're sending in Sardashny. Sardashny has a better arm than Butts. But they like to go to Sardashny when they're going to go long.
We'll look for some penalty against the Raiders.
Looks like a clipping or something.
So Scotch Plains is going to start this drive from their own 20-yard line with 2 minutes left to go. Long way to go for Raiders, but they can do it.
80 yards.
Two-minute offense, probably. No huddles after this. He'll probably call four plays in this huddle. And Mike Butts is checking in.
We're back in with Butts. See what they do on this first play. Class of 57s here at Scotch Plains today.
Their 30th reunion. They give the ball up the middle to Phil DeFalco. I don't understand that call. 2 minutes left to go in the half. You're trailing and you give the ball up the middle.
Yes, Scotch Plains a little nervous. They're deep in their territory. They don't want to give up the ball too quickly.
The clock hits down to a minute 30 as Richie Dare checks in.
Back at tight end, number 99, Skip Brantley.
Butts calls the signals.
Is that little counter?
Uh-oh. Bill, they're going to have to stop the clock to move the markers. Scotch Plains is going to be first and 10. Scotch Plains from their own 37-yard line.
That counter, the first time it worked today. They kept with it and worked. Big hole for Kresge. He just took it right up the middle. Juked a couple players down.
and we'll be right back.
Why is doing?
You know that almost one-fifth of our Navy is made up of civilians who leave their jobs at a moment's notice to help defend our country? They are members of the Naval Reserve. They take time off from their jobs to help defend our country. But for them to do that job right, they need time to train. If you're an employer, give them the time they need. With your help, our country will remain strong and ready. Support the National Guard and Reserve. Protect their future while they protect yours.
Back here, it's Scott. We're back here at Perry H. Tyson Field with minute 17 left to go in the half. Summit leading the Scotch Plains Raiders 8-0.
Wide out for Scotch Plains, number 11. And a nice battle. Fastest man on the team, run at 10-700.
That's really moving. Mike Butts is still in there. They're going to throw it this time. He's got battle out here.
There
it is. It's Noel Sardashny. Sardashny checked in during the timeout. Couldn't hit Corey Anthony going down the sideline.
Corey Anthony stopped. He should have kept running. Sardashny went in. They like to go to Sardashny with these key plays. He's got a great arm. Play time killed with a minute 10 left.
Minute 10 left to go, only 8-7 seconds off the clock.
Second down and 10 yards to go.
Number 15, Reno Starks is in for the Summit team. He's first time he's checked in today.
He's playing very
good. Sardashny's. He's going to keep it. He's got to get out of bounds.
Got the first down. Time will stop again with a minute. About a minute left on the clock. Timeout called by Scotch Plains.
I think that's their
he
third one.
He had Anthony again. If he could just pull up, if he had a little more time, pull up, hit Anthony. He was open.
There you go, Cobley. Coach Cobley out there talking, probably calling the next three plays. Got a minute left and about half the field to go. I think you were right, though, when we didn't know what they were doing and they're deep in their own territory. Time running out, giving the ball up the middle. I guess they were just trying to get into position. So they could throw the ball without really having to worry about it, getting sacked for a loss. Conversely, Summit wants to just hang on here and go to the locker room with an 8-0 lead. I mean, tremendous amount, mean a lot to them mentally just to go in there with a lead.
Exactly. Scotch Plains, if they could tie it up, they're going to be pumped up coming out for the second half. Move 50 yards.
Scotch Plains has had, though, reasonable success moving the ball. They just haven't been able to move it that last 20 yards and get it across the goal stripe. Sardashny stays in there. He drops straight drop back pass screen to Anthony. Oh, made a man miss, and he's got the sideline. And he's taken down after a big gain for Scotch Plains. 48 seconds left. Scotch Plains got to hurry up. The clock stopped for him to move the marker. Scotch Plains got to hurry up, call a play, and get ready. They're going to have the ball in about their own 18-yard line. Great play by Scotch Plains.
What they do is they send the tackle, guard, and center out there. They have three blockers out there. Quarterback drops straight back, looks to go long, throws the defense off, dumps it to him. They just go downfield. Great penetration by that defensive back.
Number 82, Flavio Anticelli had a chance to stuff up the play. But he just couldn't get it. Sardashny tries to cut it back into the middle of the field. He stopped. About 30 seconds left.
It's going to be a holding by number 44. It'll bring back another 5-10 yards.
I don't understand why he cut the ball back towards the middle of the field instead of just sprinting to the sideline.
They have 30 seconds left to get on the board here. Worst comes to worst, they can go to Cthulhu for 3 points.
How strong is his leg?
He's consistent within 30 yards.
You're right, it was a holding. It's going to be first and 20 from the 27-yard line.
Right now it'll be a 37-yard kick, but they have three more plays to work with. If they can get their time, there's 20, 20 seconds left on the clock. Scotch Plains got to hurry up or get the play out of bounds.
They can maybe get two more plays if they hurry up as the clock ticks down to 15. They call a snap. Over the middle, he's got a man. Richie Dare can't hang on to the ball. They're going to have one more shot at it, though. Great throw there by Shadashny. Put it right in the hands of number 82, Richie Dare. Pass was defended by number 7, Pete Duhott. Good defensive play. Went up there with Dare to knock it away, but opportunity lost for Scotch Plains. Analyze battle checks in for Scotch Plains.
This will be it. Scotch Plains got to hurry up.
Clock isn't going to start until they snap the ball. Maybe they can get one more play if they run it really fast. Got to throw it in the end zone. Sardashny rolls out, looks down the field for battle in the end zone. Yes! No! They're going to say he was out of the end zone. Just over the end line.
Oh,
what a
catch.
Way to end the half.
Great catch
Scotch
by
Plains.
Nice battle.
Too bad it doesn't count. At halftime, the Scotch Plains trails the Summit Hilltoppers by a score of 8-0. They were just at a nice battle. Couldn't keep his feet in bounds. It's just over the end line. Just to quickly recap the first half for you. Scotch Plains opened up with a rather impressive drive, taking it all the way to the Summit 20. Where they were stopped on downs, turned the ball over. Summit, on their first possession, tried to go deep, passed three times, and then they had to punt it away. And then Scotch Plains again drove it all the way down to the 24, where they again had to turn it over on downs. And on the next possession, Summit just drove it all the way down the field for 81 yards for a touchdown. They went for the extra point, and they got the two extra points, and that's where we are now at halftime. 8-0 in favor of the Summit Hilltoppers, and we'll be back after half.
How do you find out when an administration is corrupt? How do you find out when a government is hiding the truth? Find out about those who would like you not to find out. To become better informed about the role of a free press and how it protects your rights, contact the First Amendment Center.
Thank you. Clint Eastwood is a little upset.
Seems some misguided individuals out there are abusing our public lands, and I don't like it. And I don't think you do either. Vandalizing parks and robbing historic sites or overrunning wild areas, those are ours, and we have to save them. As I see it, these clowns can either clean up their act or get out of town.
Write Take Pride in America. Post Office Box 1339, Jessup, Maryland, 20794.
Here. Hi, and we're back here to start the second half for the Summit leading the Scotch Plains Raiders by a score of 8-0. Sean, it was a decent first half for Scotch Plains, even though they're on the wrong end of the score right now.
Well, Scotch Plains, both teams. Scotch Plains, offensively, moving the ball pretty well. They had that one counter to Chris Kresge and many bellies to Filifalco. Filifalco has about 50 yards in the first half. Those little pops up the middle. To the air, it didn't look too bad. The receivers just couldn't hold on to the ball. That one throw in the end zone. Scotch Plains moved it all the way down to the 20-yard line of Summit. Just couldn't pop it in. Defensively, they're doing all right. Summit had that good drive. Brought it all the way down the field on five first downs. And just got it downfield. Scotch Plains defense, I'm sure, is going to break down, learn their assignments, adjust to that different front that Summit's been showing, and switching the tight ends, moving the backs. So they'll break down to that.
It'll be interesting to see if Scotch Plains does go to the air more, because they did have open receivers. I guess we'll know if they come out with Noel Sardashny at quarter and not Mike Butts. Sardashny's got a really nice arm.
Scotch Plains receivers, just the whole year since the beginning, first game, been having problems with their hands. I know I dropped one myself in the first game. They just got to get it together, work on it. Quarterback's got to be able to set up, have a little more time. It's hard throwing on the run, and 90% of our pass plays are on the run. It's a rollout either way, left or right. So they'll get it going.
Plus, the field should be a little bit drier this first half. Beginning of the game, Mike Butts rolling out, tried to pull up. He just lost his balance, had to run it. Summit is making their way up to the field right now. Do you think there's any difference coming on the field first or second? What do you like to do psychologically?
Psychologically, I like coming in the beginning game, because the second half, you're calmed down. I like just that opening feeling. It's a little different. The second half, you're getting pumped again, but you got to redo the whole thing.
Right.
You got to re-pump up. It's like a whole new game again, and it's a little bit harder to get pumped up. You're more calm. You're down. You're more assignments. You relax a little bit more. That's the only difference.
It was a good half running for Phil DeFalco. He had to have at least 50, 60 yards going right off tackle. Good. So another couple hits by Keith DeFury, the sophomore, has played really well. Maurice Owens made some nice stops. Dom Cuso had some good blocks. It was a good first half for Scotch Plains. They just couldn't pop it in the zone. Thought we had it on the last play of the half, but Ananias Battle made just fell out of bounds.
That was a close one. Ananias showed some good athletic ability there, jumping over his defensive back and just getting out of the end zone. So close.
As Summit comes onto the field, and we get
I
ready.
I wonder what they're going to change. Their defense has been working pretty well. I know they're going to key on that fullback a little bit more the second half. That's pretty much the only thing they have to worry about. They pass coverage, they played well. They got the counter down pretty well. Only that one counter worked. They ran about 10 counters first half. The only thing they really have to worry about is that belly.
The captain's going out to the center of the field again.
Captains for Scotch Plains, number 75, Maurice Owens, and number 50, Nick Nitti.
Offensively for Summit, they have to, it'll be interesting to see if they go back to their passing plan, in which they had success. They had people open, they just couldn't catch it. Or if they're going to stay on the ground with those option plays that they just marched right up the field with on Scotch Plains. And it looks like Scotch Plains is going to kick off to Summit to start this second half. representing Summit for there was number 84, the tight end, Craig Smith, and number 55, Chris Spinner. And
deep for Scotch Plain. Oh, excuse me, Scotch Plain's kicking off. Kicking for Scotch Plains. Looks like number 14. Chris Laganga. And deep for Summit.
First time we've seen Summit's return team. Back deep, they've got number 30, John Kaufman. And number 33, Alan Parker. And number 42, Matt Duffy. Matt Duffy has shown great speed in that first half, getting that one play to the outside.
Kind of surprising thing, most of Summit backs are white.
Laganga gets set to kick it for Scotch Plains. There's a whistle, and the second half is underway. Good kick by Laganga, fielded by Parker. Brings it right up the center of the field. He's got a seam. One more person to beat. Oh, dragged down from behind by number
25, Corey Anthony.
Ran him down.
That
good return,
guy flies.
Though.
He was moving. He was on his toes, and he was gone. Scotch Plains didn't just get to that wall and punch through that wall quick enough. It looked like they were all just jogging down there. They didn't get down there quick enough, and they just punched it right through with that wall.
That return was right up the middle. It's a problem Scotch Plains had last year, giving up the big play on the kickoff, putting themselves in a hole right off the bat.
Summit starting with great field position on the Scotch Plains 47-yard line.
That's Matt Duffy. Oh, quickness, busted right to the outside. Oh, touchdown saving tackle there.
He was taken down by number 18, Chris Kresge. Those defensive ends have just got to get outside and contain. They're not doing that.
Great speed and quickness shown to you there by Duffy. Just punched it out to the outside.
Scotch Plains has to stay in this game. They got to stop them here. They got to show some good offense. Scotch Plains, with the loss of Hammonds, really hasn't been able to be a big play team.
That's right. They have to get a chance. And then when after Hammonds going down, Jackson went down in the first game versus Cranford, or second game versus Cranford, dealt another severe blow to Scotch Plains' hopes. And Summit gets another first down.
Taken down again by number 18, Chris Kresge.
Scotch Plains' line and linebackers are going to have to start making more tackles if they want to stop Summit here. A lot of tackles are being made by the
defensive backs.
That's right. Defensive backs making a lot of stops. It shouldn't be that way.
Coach Christador calling timeout. He's now on the field. He's going to break them down. They got to pop it up the middle. The nose guard has to stay strong. Christador really pumping them up out there.
That's right, timeout call by Scotch Plains right away. That may hurt them at the end of the game, calling that timeout right away. As Christador checks off the field.
Well, he had to do it. They were just blowing too many big plays. He had to stop the pace, calm the players down, and get them in their positions.
Cherry again in quarterback.
Mike Brennan back to his old number 51.
Chris Cherry calls the signals. That's Matt Duffy in motion. They're going to give it to him. He's got a wall. Cuts it inside. Oh, whatever Chris Dorr said, it worked. Stopped in there for a gain of about two.
Mike Brennan was in that defensive end position. He contained it pretty well.
Phil DeFalco again calls the defensive signals for Scotch Plains. It's going to be second down seven from about the 30-yard line of Scotch Plains. Summit, the 20-yard line of Scotch Plains. And Summit is just driven right up the field, right up the middle. Oh, great play there by Scotch Plains. Stuffed him right at the line of scrimmage.
Phil DeFalco hit him hard. He just went down. That's pancakes for Phil.
Good defensive there. He just shot through the gap, filled the hole.
That's the way our linebacker is supposed to be playing, that every time they come up for support, our linebacker, if our defense works correctly, our linebacker should make every tackle.
That's right. Summit comes out of the huddle. Split wide to the left. It looks like that's number 85, Bill Wahlberg. That's Alan Parker in motion. Oh, what a play by Brennan.
Mike
he
Brennan.
He was there to meet the pitch as he taunts the man while he's down.
That was some hit by Brennan.
What a stick.
Now Scotch Plains is coming out of shells, showing what they can do defensively. They broke down. Now they're hitting hard. Coach Christopher really got them pumping up. They're showing what they can do.
Great read there by Brennan. You could just see him waiting for the pitch to be made to meet that play.
He automatically has pitch man, but it looked like he was hesitating. He just wanted to hit him.
Yeah.
And boy, he hit him.
He hit him. Good penetration. Summit's going to go for it on 4th and 12. Cherry's got a good arm, so don't rule out him going to the end zone on this play.
In at nose guard now is number 67, Danny Suma. They have two receivers to the right side, putting one in motion. A little
picked
slant
off
picked
by
off.
Brennan.
Mike Brennan, interception. After one great play in the backfield, ball thrown right to him, picked off number 51, Mike Brennan.
What a defensive series for Brennan and the Scotch Plains Raiders. Mike's really fired up.
This should get him going. If the Raiders can score here, this whole game might turn around.
That's right. It's going to be first and 10 from the Scotch Plains 29-yard line. Let's see if we can get it in the end zone here. And Sardashian is going to take over the quarterbacking position in the second half.
Looks like they want to go to the air. In a tight end is number 99, Skip Brantley. They've been switching him in at number 80, Andy Lazowski, during the duration of the game. Send Kresge in motion.
Sardashian's
that
gonna throw it right out here to the flat. He's got a man. Corey Anthony puts on a move.
Shows some good feet there after breaking one tackle. About a gain of about 18 yards on that play.
It's gonna be first and 10 from about the 47-yard line of Scotch Plains. Good move there by Anthony, making one tackler miss him, getting an extra 5 yards out of the play. Skip Brantley checks out of the game. Scotch Plains lines up over the ball. Sardashian barking the signals. Giving the ball right up the middle. Stop on Anthony was made by number 77, Dennis McLean.
Gain of about one, it'll be second and nine. Out comes Lazowski, in goes Brantley, out comes Dare, in goes Nice. Battle. Battle split right. Motion by Kresge again. Looks like they went to the same pass
out.
That just worked the last time.
Broken play, and Sadashi's taking it up the middle.
He's got to start running north and south instead of east and west. Got some pushing by Brennan in number 55. Chris Spinner out there on the field.
Not as fast as Butts, but he's got a little bit better arm. Still gained about 9.5 yards on that play. It's going to be third and short. Get a good shot of Coach Schiller right there on the sideline. Trying to get a touchdown. Third and nine from the 44-yard line of Summit.
Raiders moving the ball pretty well this half. Motion again by Kresge.
Right at
this
the middle
time
to
they
DeFalco.
Pop a belly to DeFalco. He breaks nice two tackles. He carry. Oh, great run by DeFalco after a gain of about 12.
Brought down. It's going to be first and. It's going to be first and 10. It's going to be first and 10 from the Summit 28-yard line for the Raiders. Good run there by DeFalco. Right up the middle. Gain of about 12.
Raiders now moving that ball.
It's exactly how they opened up the game, driving the ball, got deep into some territory, just then the drive just halted.
Motion by Anthony.
Quick throw over the middle. Oh,
good
nice catch
hit by number seven, Pete Dunott. There's a little slant pass over the middle. Quarterback spins around, dumps it right off. Good play. Nice little play. Looks like it's a first down.
Timeout called by Summit now, as they're going to try to do the same thing Coach Christador did to Scotch Plains.
So
6 minutes,
Raider
10
offense.
Seconds left to go in this third
Captain
quarter. Scotch Plains still trails by a score of 8-0. And we'll be right back with some more action after this.
Do you have your passport?
For the third time, yes.
Do you have everything?
Kids, relax. If we weren't grown-ups, they wouldn't have let us join the Peace Corps.
Peace Corps. It's creating food systems in Africa, building homes in Costa Rica, and fighting malaria in Asia. It's teaching math and learning French. It's working side by side. It's been tough. But for 25 years, the Peace Corps has been making a difference in the world.
Mom, Dad, I'm so proud of you.
Peace Corps, the toughest job you'll ever love.
And we're back here. Scotch Plains trails by a score of 8-0. They're driving, though. They got the ball on about the 16-yard line of Summit. As they break their huddle, it's Nick Nitti doing the centering. He's going to snap the ball to Noel Sardashny.
Noel's a sophomore, another inexperienced player. He's in here. He's played bits and pieces of a couple games. Phil DeFalco finds another hole after gaining about 7 or 8 yards.
Good run there by DeFalco right up the middle. Gain of about 7, right.
Phil's got to have near 100 yards now. Hey, Phil's been doing pretty well this year.
Had an excellent game against Plainfield where he scored the winning touchdown. The only touchdown for Scotch Plains. Scotch Plains has the ball on the 9-yard line of Summit now. Second down, about 2.5, call it 3.
Scotch Plains has been popping. Scotch Plains front line has been popping some great holes for those line for the Phil to just pop through.
DeFalco the other way. Seems Scotch Plains having the greatest amount of success between the tackles. They're not having much success when they're trying to get the ball outside.
That was number 18, Chris Kresge. Had nowhere to go. The guards aren't just getting out there quick enough to log those ends. And the force by the defensive backs this summer has been really, really forceful. Got a third down in about 1.5.
So Ashney calls the signals. DeFalco right up the middle for a first down and then some. Look at Phil just carry people.
He carried
the goal line.
He carried 4 or 5 players.
That was all DeFalco on that one. He just moved the pile back about 4 or 5 yards.
The first down was accomplished by the line and Phil. Then Phil brought another 5 yards for himself. They better give it to Phil again. He earns this touchdown.
That's right.
Pop it again to Phil. One more time. Put it in the end zone.
First down and goal. Ball on the half-yard line.
They better give this one to DeFalco. Play's been working great this whole series.
So Ashley takes
Kresge.
A snap. DeFalco, touchdown.
There it is.
Scotch Plains is back in this game. Makes a score. Now it's interesting to see if Schiller goes for the 2 points right here and tie the game, or if he kicks an extra point and thinks he'll get another score.
Well, I'm not the coach, but I'd go for the 2 because the scoring hasn't been too
See, I'd go just the other way. I think I'd take the sure one, hope for some defense, and then maybe get another score outright.
Last week, the first game we played Plainfield. It was 7-6. We stopped them. It could be an 8-7 game. You got to go for the 2.
Because
exactly if you're going to score again, you're going to go ahead. So you have to go for the 2.
That's exactly what Coach Schiller's going to do.
Well, I'm sure they'll give that to DeFalco again.
Same play.
There it
DeFalco
is.
DeFalco up the middle, and he's stopped short. Didn't make it. So Scotch Plains trails by a score of 8-6. Good offensive series, though, for Scotch Plains. Getting a big play, turnover made by Brennan, causing that turnover, and Scotch Plains just marched the ball 70 yards right up the field, doing pretty much whatever they wanted to.
Phil DeFalco with that touchdown run. They've been giving him belly after belly. He's getting a workout today. Also a linebacker, starting linebacker, leading that defense. Phil gives everything he's got every play.
Scotch Plains going to kick off. And again, we see the return unit of Summit. They had a great return the last time. Let's see if Scotch Plains can stuff him up.
Scotch Plains got to hustle down there and pop right through that front line.
Deep for Summit is number 42, Matt Duffy, and number 33, Alan Parker. Alan Parker's the one who had that great return. Both of these players for Summit can really fly. And Leganga gets set to kick it for Scotch Plains.
I'm sure DeFalco's really tired right now, but he's going to pump himself up and get down that field as quick as he can.
And Raiders scored with almost exactly 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Short kick by Leganga. It's going to be taken by one of the up men. Oh,
good tackle by number 46, Anthony Cucurillo. He got down that field rather quickly.
Ball was fielded by number 30, John Kaufman, and Summit's going to start with a ball from their own 26. Although it wasn't the longest kick in the world, good coverage there by Scotch Plains.
Scotch Plains defense, see what they could do this possession by Summit. They stop him here, that's going to be all right. Danny Suma raising his hands, let's get him.
Scotch Plains really pumped up now. Mike Brennan's out there on the end. Flags. Let's see what it is. It's called on Scotch Plains. Lining up in the neutral zone. It's going to be first and five for Summit instead of first and 10. First and five from the 32-yard line.
See if we can get a fight song out of the Raider band here.
Chris Cherry calls the signals.
Motion by
Duffy
number 42.
In motion. He gets the ball, and he stopped after a gain of about three. Tackle made by number 67.
Brennan put that play inside. The linebackers just got to get up there and fill. They're not scraping hard enough. It's going to be about second and one. There you see a shot of Coach Christador coordinating the defense.
DeFalco checks in with the play. Scotch Plains got to hurry up and get set. Second and short for Summit. Chris Cherry takes the ball. Option. Strung out nicely by the Scotch Plains defense. Good play there by Brennan on that end.
That was a very good play by Brennan. Brennan's coming. Brennan's a tough little guy, man. Force got to be coming up by Corey Anthony. He was hanging out back there. If he waited for the runner to get to him, it would have been another first down. He's got to come up and make that force fight off that block.
So it's going to be third down in about one and a half.
2:35 left in the third quarter.
Big play here by Summit. Scotch Plains can hold them, get the ball back, get the go-ahead score. They give the ball right up the middle, and he stopped short of the first down by a swarming Raider defense. Ball is given to number 25, Paul Fleming. Ananias Battle and Dan Suma check off the field for the Raiders.
Going for a block. Block.
Almost blocked by the Raiders.
One hell of a punt. Looks like a roll out about the 21-yard line. He cooked out
a good
50 yards.
Good
kick
by John Kaufman. Whistles on the field. The ref seems to be talking to calling an unsportsmanlike on a player or a coach. I wonder what's going on down there.
They're saying something about the helmet, the switching of the helmets. I think the numbers on the back or something. Coach Schiller is really upset. Complaining about Brantley and DeFalco. DeFalco's helmet broke. He switched helmets with Brantley. Don't know exactly what they're talking about there.
Coach Schiller is fuming about that call, whatever it was. Maybe it'll just serve to pump up the Raiders even more. Scotch Plains is going to start from the ball on about their own 30-yard line.
It's going way back. Ball went out about on the 20. See how far they bring it back from there. Can't understand that. I guess it was offsetting penalties or something, but it went nowhere. Or maybe someone just declined it.
Right.
Because they got a good kick out of that one.
A minute 33 left to go in the half. Tardashny, all right away to Anthony over the middle. Can't hang on to the ball. Can't throw it any better than that. Laid it right in his hands, couldn't hold on to
it. He had to hesitate. Anthony wasn't looking. Anthony looked, he put it right there, and Anthony dropped it.
I think he heard the footsteps coming over the middle, but you still got it. You got to catch the ball. It's going to be second down and 10 from the 20-yard line.
Sounds like the Raider band's tuning up here a little bit. We got a nice split right.
Wilson Dashney, option to Kresge, turns it upfield. That seems to be a very slippery part of the field because that's where Mike Butts lost his balance earlier.
Sir Dashney was clocked after he pitched that ball on the play.
Gain of about a yard and a half. Would have been much more had he been able to keep his balance. McNitty does the centering for Scotch Plains. Sardashny looks over the defense.
Anthony in motion. Quick there's pass. That pass. A hard stop, but it looks like it's definitely going to be a first down. Good play by Scotch Plains Raiders.
Made by Kresge. Hung on to the ball. As the clock ticks down to 30 seconds remaining in the third quarter. First down.
Pete Dunha, after hitting Kresge really hard, looks like he blacked out a little bit. You see some stars hitting with your head sometimes.
That's right.
He'll come off the field for at least one play. A little shaken up. I had that happen in a Plainfield game. I had a little collision with the fullback. I didn't know where I was for a little while. 30 seconds left in the third quarter.
This should be the last play of the quarter. So Dashney now handling the quarterback for Scotch Plains. And give it up the middle to DeFalco. Who is one step away from breaking that. He was brought down by number 55. Chris Spinner, co-captain, linebacker.
Got about 6 yards on that play. It'll be second down and four for the Raiders. This quarter's over. Raiders got to bring it down there, punch it in just one more time.
That's right. As the third quarter ends with the score, Summit 8, Scotch Plains 6, and Scotch Plains driving. They switch ends of the field. Excellent quarter for Scotch Plains. Came out, first play, they let up a good return, but then they really toughened up on defense. Brennan caused the turnover.
Assholes.
And we'll be right back.
Hey, John.
Fitzgerald Kennedy, do solemnly swear.
I, John Fitzgerald Kennedy, do solemnly swear.
And I will faithfully execute
the office of the Presidency of the United States.
The office of the Presidency of the United States.
And will, to the best of my ability,
preserve, protect, and defend
the Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
The Constitution, the words we live by.
Our Scotch Plains get set for the first play of the quarter. It's a dive right to DeFalco. DeFalco's in the secondary. Good play by Phil.
Motion by Kresge. Linebacker blitz. That's what happened. He went right on the quarterback. Quarterback, Noel Sardash, and he just got DeFalco. So DeFalco had that hole free, got past the linebackers, broke two or three tackles in the secondary, and about 30 yards on play.
Excellent run by Phil.
Falco having one hell of a game today. Off comes Brennan. Brennan also a second string guard, having one good day on defense. Interception, great play in the backfield. Start this good drive by Scotch Plains. There's that counter.
Stuffed. Play was broken up by number 50, Pat Natal. Scotch Plains get set for another play.
Looking for a waggle pass here.
Second down, 13. Sardashny, quick drop over the middle.
Go!
Kresge dragged down from behind. Great play.
That pass has worked every time, except the one time Anthony dropped the ball. Play was still working. Great play by Kresge.
Sardashny playing excellently.
That was a good pass. He got it right past the defenseman. Kresge with the good catch, broke the tackle, and down the field for another 20 yards. Scotch Plains gonna pop it in here. I can just feel it.
Sardashny's playing excellent in place of Mike Butts. Got an excellent arm, accurate. Oh. DeFalco.
I just keep watching him. He has carried somebody every time he's run the ball. He just carried two or three Summit players that time.
He's worked hard today. Sardashny hit as soon as he hands the ball off, and Phil just carried somebody for 2 yards.
He had nothing, and he turned it into 2 yards. Great play to DeFalco.
Sardashny drops back, being chased down. He's got to throw it. Oh.
Summit totally picked up that screen that time. They had the wall broken. They had the receiver covered. And Sardashny had to run for his life.
Somebody missed an assignment. Sack was made by number 25, Paul Fleming.
Lost about 15.
For a loss of 15 yards. Sardashny should have just unloaded that. Sign of inexperience. Third down and about 25. Sardashny, he's gonna have to put it up now. Good block, he's got the time. He's got the man. Ananias battle. Somebody, I think Ananias ran a post and Sardashny threw it to a flag. Somebody messed up somewhere.
Sardashny had to rush it and battle, just didn't have his eye on the ball at all. He didn't locate it in time. Battle would have got there if he could have saw it.
He had him. Scotch Plains gonna have to go for it. As Scotch Plains get set for a big fourth down play, that sack really hurt them, Sean. They were going in for the go-ahead score. And then one play just turned it all around. Roll out by Shadash. He's got a man. He throws it in the end zone, just overthrows him.
I think even if he didn't.
He was a little bit over the line of scrimmage when he threw it. First down for Summit. They're going to start with the ball in their own 29-yard line.
That was a big play by Summit, that sack. There you see Coach Christador and Coach Colby on your right. Near, right in the front of the screen is Coach Christador, defensive coordinator. .839 left in the game. Summit up 8-6. That was a key drive by Scotch Plains. They can still move the ball. Hold them here, make them punt, bring it back down the field.
Ball given right up the middle. Good play there by DeFalco. Just grabbed a hold of his shirt and pulled him down.
Falco's backside backer, he came on a good tight scrape. Fury got blocked out by the guard there. He was on the, he would have been hitting him right at the line of scrimmage, but he got a good block by probably his guard.
Good play there by Phil. Pull him down, hold him to a limit of a 3-yard gain. Summit has it now, second down and 7. Chris Cherry's quarterback. He takes a snap, gives it to number 33, Alan Parker, who just sprints to the outside. That was pure speed, Sean. We had him in there. He just outran Phil DeFalco to the outside.
Falco on a scrape, just couldn't get there quick enough. That guy flies. Both number 33 and number 42 for Summit is just have pure blazing speed.
Very fast. It's going to be second down and about 9. Face mask called on Scotch Plains. That's going to move the ball. Scotch Plains, too closely penalties this quarter. 7 minutes, 47 seconds left to go in the game. And that puts a ball in Scotch Plains territory on about on the Scotch Plains 46. Chris Cherry calls the signals. The sun comes out here at Scotch Plains Vanwood. Gives the ball up the middle, number 25, Pete Fleming, and he's just stuffed by a host of defenders.
Good pressure by the Raider defense that time. They just couldn't get a handle on him.
It's going to be second down and about 7. Ball on the 44-yard line. Cherry calling signals. Gives it to Matt Duffy, who just sprints to the outside. Run down by Chris Kresge.
Corey Anthony got caught inside. That's what broke that play outside. You can't let these Summit running backs get outside. They just got some great speed.
Very fast. Matt Duffy, he just out-sprinted Corey Anthony to the outside. Got to contain. First and 10 from the 30-yard line. A little mix-up there in the backfield, and a Scotch Plains stuffed it at the line. Carried by Peter Fleming. Stop made by number 50, Nick Nitti. Second down and 10. Second down and 10. Ball on the second down and 10. Ball up. Little mix up there. Hit made by Cucurullo. Backfield. Loss of about 5 yards. It's going to be third and 15 from the 35-yard line. Good stick there by Cucurullo. Matt Duffy had a little problem finding the handle on the ball.
Cook would have got to him, though. Loss of about, what, 4? On that play.
Motion by number 84, Charlie Smith.
It's a tight end.
Anthony Parker cuts it inside. He's got a hole. Oh,
great,
nice play
by
Kresge.
Kresge's having one heck of a game today. He's been making some really key tackles for Scotch Plains.
Chase him all the way across the field after a gain. It's going to be fourth down and 10. Great play there by Kresge and some good moves there by Parker. He made that cut on a dime, but he was pulled down right away.
Cucurullo sent that play inside. The linebacker should have been there scraping. I don't know. He probably got mixed up in the backfield, but great play by Kresge coming from the total opposite side of the field. Good job by Kresge. 4:50 left in this quarter. Half game, the whole thing.
As Craig Smith goes in motion and screws up the schedule. Flag called, probably illegal motion on Summit. Yup, that's exactly what it is. It's going to be fourth down and 15. That much motion, two guys started to move at the same time.
Is that a fight song, Steve?
I think so.
I think that's their favorite song.
Fourth
I'm going to have that memorized by the end of the day. Ba 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 ba.
Cherry drops back.
He's hit hard when he releases that ball.
Good coverage there by Ananias Battle. And a good stick by DeFalco as soon as
Falco, Cucurullo, DeFury, everybody was in there that time. He still got off the ball, though.
Good coverage. Good coverage by Ananias Battle downfield. He had the inside track and just denied the man the ball. It's going to be first and 10 for Scotch Plains from their own 35-yard line. They have 4 minutes and 34 seconds to go ahead in this game. Summit has really had only that one drive in which that was the one they scored. Otherwise, Scotch Plains defense has been amazingly sound. DeFalco up the middle, he's going nowhere.
Maurice Owens was kind of excited on that play. He had some guy, he kicked his player all the way out near the sideline, put him right on his butt.
Tackle was made by number 82. Flavio Antitelli. Acitelli, excuse me. I'm going to be hearing that song in my sleep.
That's for sure.
The option play to Corey Anthony is stopped by number 82.
There's a flag.
Flavio Acitelli.
That's going to be roughing, I know that. Definitely roughing. That's going to be first down.
The ref explaining the options to Captain Nick Nitti. And it looks like it will be. It's going to go against Summit.
Instead of second and 16, it's now second.
It's going to be a
excuse
first.
Me, first and three.
First and about three. No, excuse me, it's third and. Third and three. Little mix up between the linesmen and the chain movers.
Nope. And the coach and the referee too.
Everything seemed to be straightened out.
This is a key play right here.
Third and three, big play for Scotch Plains.
They have to bring it down. They have to.
I imagine DeFalco right off tackle.
Offside. There we go. First down.
First down, Scotch Plains.
There we go.
Went to a long count and caught him.
Scotch Plains used to going on one. Does it almost the whole game. And just catches them. Sometimes they'll just go on two and it'll catch that defense right off guard.
First down. Costly penalty for Summit. Big break for Scotch Plains.
See what I was talking about with the two? With the two at the two extra point? The extra point needed two.
That's right.
Because the scoring, both offenses aren't going too well today because the defenses are a lot stronger.
That's right. It's going to be from just about midfield, 48-yard line, first and 10, Scotch Plains. Tadashny's going to go to the air. He's got a man, Anthony. Corey Anthony hangs on to that one. It's going to be first down, got out of bounds, stopped the clock with 3 minutes and 16 seconds left in the game.
Scotch Plains moving that ball rather well now. Hopefully, if they can't get in the end zone, they can get it inside the 20 and maybe go to a field goal.
Yep. That was a gain of about 15. So Dashney stands over center.
Wide left is there, motion. Extended motion. That's 9.9 waggle.
Oh, just out of the reach of Dare. Good effort there by Richie Dare. Pass just a little bit too far away.
They had a little bit too much pressure in there, too. There you see Coach Schiller.
Second down and 10. So Dashney drops back, lays it out on the flat, just over the head of
Kresge.
Chris Kresge. Third down and 10.
See that little spin around by the quarterback and a little slant over the middle again. Maybe that'll work.
That's right, it's worked all the other times. Just got to hang on to the ball and catch it. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go to that play.
That's what I'd look for. D-backs are playing deep.
He's got a man over the middle.
Interference. All right. He got him that time.
Interference is going to be called on number 42, Matt Duffy. He grabbed Richie Dare's arms as soon as Richie started to turn around to catch it.
It's been close every time they called it. It's the Anthony Cucurillo. That'll be a first down. Big play for Scotch Plains.
Break for Scotch Plains, first and 10 from the 14-yard line. No, 18-yard line.
24.
I get all mixed up with the lines. DeFalco up the middle, he stopped.
They got to get it inside that 20. At least.
As the clock ticks down to about 2 minutes and 30 seconds left in the game. Second down and about 9.
I hope they go to that pass play. That works well every time.
Sardashti, pressure from the outside. Big rush from the inside that time by number 25, Paul Fleming. He's a junior. Stop the clock. 2 minutes, 23 seconds left. Scotch Plains trailing Summit by a score of 8-0.
I'm really curious to see what they do if they get stopped here, if they will go to the foot of Cthulhu or Laganga.
Last year with Mark Drozic, I don't think they would hesitate. But
no, Drozic had awesome foot. He was consistent from 40. Oh, that was the play. They were ready for it. I think they were waiting for it every time. Here's the decision. Coach Schiller and Coach Colby have to make. Timeout called by Scotch Plains.
They're going to think this over.
Wise decision.
I think they have to go for it, because I really don't think they'd get the ball back if they gave it up. It'd be a long kick.
33 yards, 34-yard kick.
30.
They have to make the choice. They get it, put them ahead by one, but then you got to figure they're going to have about 2 minutes left to do what they can with it.
That's right. And we'll be right back with more of this exciting football game.
There was a time when an 18-year-old couldn't vote. A time when there was no meaningful way for young adults to express their opinions. What changed that? The 26th Amendment to the Constitution of the United States. The Constitution, the words we live by.
The middle of an exciting game. 2 minutes, 19 seconds left to go in the game. Fourth down and about seven on the 20-yard line of Summit. Scotch Plains is driving, and they're going for it. They've converted three times on this drive. Let's hope they can do it again. Roll out by Zdashny, cuts it up. First down, Scotch Plains.
All right, Noel Zdashny with the beautiful run. Cut it back inside. Summit was hanging back, wanted to stop it from first down, just hung back a little too much, and Zdashny took it up the field for the first down.
Great play by Noel Zdashny. Big conversion by Scotch Plains. Puts the ball inside the 10. First and goal from about the 9-yard line.
Let the time start running. They should let the time start running.
2 minutes left.
Just play their plays.
Zdashny, same play
anything.
Up the middle. He's met right at the line of scrimmage.
He was hit pretty hard by number 84.
That's Craig Smith, tight end and defensive end.
Gained about one.
As clock ticks down to about a minute 30. Plenty of time. They're in good field goal position.
Worst comes to worst, they can definitely get the field goal now. Kickers better be warming up on the sidelines.
Give the ball to DeFalco up the middle. He's stopped.
Late hit, maybe. Should have seen a flag there by number 24. He came in after the whistle.
Clock ticks down to about a minute. Third down. I think they're going to throw it in the end zone here, Sean.
Might be a little dangerous. Well, Noel's got a good arm, though. He'll make the best that he can.
Goes down to a minute. Kicker, Cicatulo warming up on the sidelines. Excellent drive here by Scotch Plains. To DeFalco up the middle. He's met.
Stop dead.
And it's
Scotch Plains.
Down.
Calls
timeout.
Great play. Here
and
we
all
come
comes
in.
A field goal unit. Great run, sets it up. Ball's on about the 3-yard line.
Cthulhu's in there.
It's about an extra point shot. I expect him to make this kick, but I just hope he doesn't think too much about it.
Cranford game, he missed two extra points. Union, we didn't see him kick because we didn't score. Every other time he's kicked, it's been good. So
let's hope.
He's batting about 500. This is it. See what he can do here. This could be the game.
Big play. Noel Zdashny has played excellent QB here in the second half since taking over. He's engineered the Scotch Plains team like he's been playing varsity for his whole life. Cthulhu, you can see warming up. He looks excited. He just can't think too much about this kick. Just concentrating on getting a good plant and swinging his leg through.
It's a tough angle. Very tough angle.
From the right hash mark.
They're shooting in from the whole left side.
Mike Butts is the holder. Here we go. Snap, it's good. The kick is up.
And it's good.
Yeah, Scott Plains takes a 9-8 lead on the kick by Danny Cotullo.
We are going to party tonight.
30 seconds left in the game. Scotch Plains comes up with a field goal with 30 seconds left. What an exciting drive that was, Sean. They converted. They came through in all clutch situations.
Game's not over yet. We saw the blazing speed of those two backs. Cotullo, see if Coach Schuller elects to keep it on the ground. Kick that play on the ground. Keep it away from those two deep backs.
Hit a little squib kick. Excellent game by Scotch Plains.
Here we go. Yeah.
Great play by Scotch Plains. They came through in all clutch situations. Converted on three third downs and a fourth down. On the way to the winning field goal. Hopefully winning field goal.
I gotta play next week.
As LaGanga gets set to kick it off. There it is, a little squib kick. Fielded by number 30. He's taken down.
Time's gonna be running. Clock stopped at 25 seconds left. Raider defense has to play prevent. Stay back. Don't let any big plays.
Don't let anybody behind you. I imagine we'll see someone aired out. What an outstanding drive by Scotch Plains. Three third down conversions, a fourth down conversion, and making the field goal. Michael Butts did a good job there too. Low snap, he handled it, and Danny Cotullo was able to put it through. Drop back.
Down 11
big
seconds.
Big rush.
Yeah.
Big
sack.
Rush. 6-4-3-2. Timeout.
3 seconds left.
Summit gets a timeout with
Danny Suma,
left.
Number 67 junior with the sack.
With 3 seconds left here, Scotch Plains. Raiders leading 9-8, having taken the lead with 30 seconds left to go. Summit just called a timeout. They're gonna have one more snap.
Let's get big pressure from the Raider defense now. They gotta go to the air. They should put linebackers all the way back and no one should get past Corey Anthony Nice.
Ananias Battle is about 30 yards deep. And Coach Christador is telling them to drop even deeper. They are no lie 40 yards away from the line of scrimmage.
This is it.
Sets it up, little pop over the middle. Oh, flea flicker. The old hook and lateral play, but it's no good.
It's all
Scotch
over.
Scotch Plains wins the game. What an exciting game. Great victory for Scotch Plains.
Final score, 9-8, Scotch Plains. Wins.
Great game by Scotch Plains. Oh my. Exciting drive. Great game by Phil DeFalco.
Fucking shit. I want to go. Cut it.
Just to wrap this game up, Scotch Plains trailed at halftime by a score of 8-0, having given up a touchdown early in the second quarter. They came out in the third quarter, slowly started to take control of the game. Scored a touchdown in the fourth quarter, elected to go for two where they were stopped. They were stopped on the two-point conversion, got the ball back, and put together a clutch drive with about 4 minutes left, taking the ball all the way down to the three-yard line before kicking a field goal with 30 seconds left, and that's how it ended. The score, Scotch Plains Raiders 9, Summit 8. Next week, we'll have you with us with the Westfield Blue Devils, which should be a great game. For now, this has been Steve Edwards with Sean Flannery.